There are consistent bits of wisdom you hear during hurricane season when there's a storm brewing. If you're along the Gulf Coast, you know the ones. Stash enough water for everyone in your family, have an evacuation plan that includes pets, and get your beer on ice early. Forecasters also typically have their own too, like it's the upper right side of the storm that's the strongest. So why is that? First, let's talk about what's the right side of the storm. Typically, geography would want us to think more along the lines of north, south, east, and west, but the right side of a storm is defined by how it's moving. Storm swirling to the north, that means the right side is on the east. Storm heading west, the right side is on the north. Think of it like a moving clock. No matter which way the 12 is pointing, the right side is always between 12 and 6. Now, what makes the upper right side the stronger or dirtier side of the storm? It's because that's where the strongest winds are located. The strength of the storm's movement combines with the strength of the storm's winds, and voila, you have a nastier storm with stronger winds and higher storm surge. For my math nerds out there, think of it this way. If a hurricane with 90 mile per hour winds is moving at 10 miles per hour, it would have winds at 100 miles per hour on the right side and 80 on the left. Remember our clock example? This means the toughest, nastiest part of a hurricane is going to be somewhere between 12 and 3, no matter which way that clock is pointing. What it all means is, if you have to be in a hurricane's path, it's best to be on the left side. And remember, all of this gets reversed if you're south of the equator. Do you have Louisiana questions? We've got Louisiana answers. I'm Chelsea Braced with Latitude by NOLA.com.